This is the continuation of first video. The question is, what is circulation ratio? It is the ratio of mass flow rate of circulating water to the rate of steam generation. GFW is rate of feed water and GS is rate of steam. So K equal to G, rate of feed water, divided by G, rate of steam. Next question, what is the value of circulation ratio for natural circulation? This usually ranges from 4 to 30. Next, what is the value of circulation ratio for forced circulation? It is 3 to 10. What is the value of circulation ratio for once through steam boilers? It is unity. Why is the value of circulation ratio for once through boilers unity? Answer is, in such units, the entire feed water is continuously converted to steam as it passes through the evaporation surfaces. Means rate of feed water equal to rate of steam. So in here we can see the once through boiler transformation of boiler feed water. In first figure, boiler feed water pump is there. It is going through the economizer and the water is converted to superheater. As the black zone is heat flow and the white zone, gray zone, is steam. In the transition zone, the outlet is steam. Once through boiler circuit is the second picture. It is showing the feed water pump is going to the feed the water to the economizer. Through the distribution header, the evaporator is next to the distribution header, then after the superheater. After the outlet is superheated steam. This is the once through boiler. The next question, can once through boilers operate at subcritical as well as supercritical pressure? Yes. What is the difference between a closed hydraulic system and an open hydraulic system? The former features a drum that acts both as a reservoir to provide working fluid circulation and separate water from steam, while the latter has no drum and the working fluid passes through the evaporating tubes only once. How can boilers be classified on the basis of tube shape and position? Answer is, depending upon the tubular heating surface, boiler may be classified as straight tube boilers, bent tube boilers. Depending on inclination of tubular heating surface, horizontal boilers, vertical boilers and inclined boilers. Next question is, what is the difference between horizontal and vertical boiler? Answer, the difference basically lies in the geometric position of the boiler. A horizontal boiler has its principal axis horizontal or slightly inclined, while that of vertical boiler is perpendicular to the horizontal plane. So we see the pictures. In vertical boiler, boiler feed water pump inlet is left side bottom. So the feed water is circulating. The steam is upper of the vertical tubes. So the flue gas passes through the vertical lines. We can see the blowdown in right side bottom. This is the vertical boiler. In horizontal boiler, the feed water pump inlet is drum. Right side bottom. In top is the boiler drum. So top of the boiler drum is steam. The flue gas flow through the horizontal tubes. The blowdown is right side of the tube bottom. This is the horizontal boiler. The next question, what is the single tube boiler? A boiler having only one fire tube is called single tube boiler, Cornish or simple vertical boiler. What is multi-tube boiler? A boiler having two or more fire or water tubes is called multi-tube boiler.
How can boilers be classified on the basis of use? This is done on the basis of nature of surface service they perform. Customarily, boilers are called stationary and mobile. Stationary is these are land basis boilers. Mobile, these are mounted on marine vessels and steam locomotives. What is stationary boiler? The boiler is, as its name implies, is not required to be transformed from one place to another. What is mobile boilers? Locomotive and marine boilers, which are moved from place to place, and mobile boilers. How may stationary boilers classified further? They can classify it further depending on the specific service they meet. Stationary boilers for central station, district heating. Stationary boilers for process steam generating. Stationary boilers for power generation. Stationary boilers, again I am repeating, stationary boilers for central station heating and process steam generation and for power generation. Stationary boilers used for heating are often classified as residential boilers, commercial boilers. How can boilers be classified on the basis of furnace position? Depending on the relative location of the furnace of the boiler, the boiler classification can be made by externally fired furnace and internally fired furnace. What is the difference between external fire and internal fired boilers? In case of external fired boilers, the combustion of fuel takes place in the combustion outside of the boiler shell. While in the case of internally fired boilers, the boiler chamber is provided inside the boiler shell. How can boilers classified as the basis of tube contents? Depending on whether the flue gas of water is in the tube side, boiler can be classified as fire tube boilers and water tube boilers. Give us some examples of fire tube boilers. Locomotive boiler, Cochrane boiler, Cornish boiler. In locomotive boiler, we can see in the picture the gas flow circuit. In locomotive boiler, the flue gas is going through the tubes in horizontal, then it is going vertically on the right side of the boiler. In top of the boiler, the steam dome is there and steam is collecting in the top of the boiler, and we can restrict the steam from the top of the boiler. This is the locomotive boiler. This is very simple. And locomotive boiler water circulating system is, feed water is inlet in left side of the tube and drain also in the left side. Feed water and drain, it is also in right side also. The sludge is collecting in the bottom of the drum. Steam outlet and is provided on the top of the dome. So this is the locomotive boiler water circulation system. These have what? The question is, give some examples of fire tube boilers. This locomotive boiler, Cochrane boiler and Cornish boiler. These have hot flue gas in tube side and boiler feed water in shell side. So the next question, give some examples of water tube boilers. Babcock and Wilcox boiler is water tube boiler, and Stirling boiler, Longmouth boiler, Yarrow boiler. Again, examples of water tube boilers are Babcock and Wilcox boiler, Stirling boiler, Longmouth boiler, Yarrow boiler. All these have boiler feed water in tube side, hot flue gas in the shell side. Babcock and Wilcox boiler, Stirling boiler, Longmouth boiler, Yarrow boiler. Next question. What are the comparative advantages and disadvantages of fire tube and water tube boilers? Answer is, in the parameters, fire tube boilers, water tube boilers. A rate of steam generation is less rapid. in water tube, more rapid rate of steam generation, rapid. So suitable, second known is suitably for power plants. Unsuitable in fire tube boiler, water tube boiler suitable. All major power plants are based on this. Operating steam pressure is limited to 25 kilogram per kg kg per centimeter square. Water tube boiler we can exceed 125 kg per centimeter square. Chances of explosion is less, in water tube is more. Risk damage due to explosion is much more, in water tube boiler much less. Water treatment not very necessary, as minor scaling would not go far enough to case overheating and tube bursting. In water tube boiler, required as scaling will lead to tube bursting. Flow space requirement is much, in here water tube boiler less. Cost and construction is fire tube boiler higher, water tube boiler much less. Transportation inconvenient due to large size of the shell. Water tube boiler comparatively easier. Skill required for efficient operation is less in fire tube boiler. Water tube boiler skill is required more. That's it. Now we can see the next video. Thank you. In further.